Say this here with another SOLIDWORKS tech tip. Today I want to talk about adding balloons to some assemblies in your drawings. If you have tried to do that in the past, you may notice that whenever you try to add a balloon to your drawings, SOLIDWORKS always shows the item number related to the components of a subassembly instead of the subassembly itself. Now the question of course here is how we can add a balloon and show the item number of the subassembly, not its components. Well, there are three different ways that we can do that, and we are going to cover them here in this short video. You can use the origin of your subassembly, you can use an assembly sketch, or you can use multiple bill of materials. So let's start with the first technique, using the origin of the subassembly. If you look at this drawing that I prepared, if you look at the bill of material, you can see that I have one single subassembly in this main assembly, that handle with three components in it. Now, as I said, if I try to add a balloon to any one of the components of this subassembly, you can see that SOLIDWORKS will show the item number related to those components. Now, the first workaround is to use the origin of the subassembly. Now let's see how that works. First of all, I need to see the origins in my view. So I'm going to go to View, Hide, Show, and click on Origins to make them visible. Now I happen to know that this is the origin of my subassembly. So at this point, if I add a balloon to that origin, you can see that SOLIDWORKS will add or will show the item number of the subassembly there. Okay, so that is one way of doing it. Now in some cases the origin of your subassembly is not in a suitable location to, you know, to add a balloon to that. So what about those scenarios? In those cases, what you can do is to use an assembly sketch. Let me open this subassembly, my subassembly. So this is the my subassembly that handle that I showed you before. What I need to do here is to add a sketch here at the assembly level. So I'm gonna select this top face, start a new sketch, and you can use any, or we can add any one of these to the entities that we have there. I'm gonna use the point, and we'll add a point right on the center of that face, just like that. Accept and exit the sketch, and right there I have my assembly sketch. Now let me go back to my drawing. I have to make sure that the drawings or the sketches are visible, so I'm going to turn that on. And also you have to make sure that the sketch in the design tree is set to be visible. Okay, and right there I have my point. Now at this point you can simply add a balloon to that point, and again SOLIDWORKS will show the item number of the subassembly. Okay, now in our third scenario we'll see how we can use multiple bill of materials to basically do the same thing, to show the item number of the subassembly. Now this third technique is especially useful when you have multiple views, and in one view you want to show the item number of the subassembly, in the other view you want to show the item numbers of the components of that subassembly. So let me delete the balloons that I have there, and also I'm going to go to Hide, Show, and make sure that the sketches are not visible. Also I don't need to see the origins anymore. Okay, so let me add a detail view to my drawing. I'm going to place it there. It's a little big for my sheet, so I'm going to change the scale to 1:1. Okay, perfect. So that is my detail view right there. In this case, as I mentioned that before, I want to add a balloon to this view and show the item number of the subassembly, and then I want to add three balloons to this view, to my detail view, and show the item numbers of the components of my subassembly. Okay, so in order to do so, what I need to do is to add a new bill of material. So I'm going to go to tables, bill of material. This is my reference view. It's an indented with detailed numbering bill of material, the exact same as my first bill of material. Press OK, and I'm going to put it somewhere outside of my sheet. Okay. Now, there are two things that I need to do before adding my balloon to my views. First of all, I need to expand this bill of material and zoom in and click on that minus sign next to the subassembly. Doing so, it will only show the subassembly as one single row in my bill of material. Then I'm going to right click on my main view, my first view, go to the properties, and we'll make sure that it's pointing to that new bill of material. Okay, it will the balloons that I'm going to add to that view will read their values from this new bill of material. Okay, now at this point, if I go to annotation, add balloons, and if I add a balloon to any one of the components of this subassembly, you can see that solvers will show the item number of the subassembly instead of the item number of the components of the subassembly. Now for my other view, right hand side view, first of all, I'm going to make sure that it's reading the property, or it's reading its values from the my first bill of material number 2. And in this bill of material, as you can see, I'm showing all the components of the subassembly. So if I add a balloon to this view, as you can see, Solvers will show the item numbers related to the components of the subassembly.